Hello people, in this video we want to look at tear film, correct? So basically, in the last video what have we looked at? We have looked at lacrimal apparatus, right? The lacrimal gland, the passages for lacrimal secretion, that is the puncta, the canaliculi, the lacrimal sac, and the nasolacrimal duct. So hope you remember, we have seen what and all, the lacrimal gland that secretes, the ducts, then the puncta, then the canaliculi, lacrimal sac, the nasolacrimal duct. Here you have valve of Hasner, correct? So this much you have seen in the previous video. So all the anatomy, the blood supply, all that we have seen, nerve supply, blood supply, all that we saw. Now let us move on to tear film. Basically tear film, there are three parts in it. So you have the mucus layer. So if you have seen this photo also in the last video, it has been explained, right? The tear film, okay, basically there are three parts to it. You have the mucus layer, then you have the mucus layer, then you have the watery layer. Let us put watery in blue. You have the watery layer, then you have the oily layer, which we'll put in yellow, okay. So you have three parts to this tear film, correct? That's why it's called as a tear film. Okay guys, so now let us read from the textbook. So basically, the structure of the fluid covering the cornea, so it is called as precorneal film. So before the cornea you have what is called as the precorneal film. So the cornea has been represented here. Before the cornea you have this film that is called as the tear film. Precorneal film. So this was first described by Wolf. They are saying basically there are three layers here in this tear film. You have the mucus layer, aqueous layer, and the lipid layer or the oily layer. You have the mucus layer, aqueous layer or the water layer, and you have the lipid or the oily layer, correct? So what and all are there? Mucus layer, aqueous layer, and then you have the lipid or oily layer. Okay, so first of all, read about the mucus layer. So it is the innermost layer. Okay, it consists of mucin secreted by the conjunctival goblet cells, glands of Mans. So who is secreting this mucus layer? See, it is not coming from the lacrimal gland, it is coming from the conjunctival goblet cells. So the conjunctiva has goblet cells, so that is secreting this mucin. Okay. And then you have from the glands of Mans. Okay. Are you able to see the color? Color is not proper, right? So let's use a better color. Hold on. So mucus layer, who is secreting? Goblet cells of conjunctiva. Then you have the glands of Mans. So if you remember our conjunctiva video, we have seen this mucin secretory glands, glands of conjunctiva, glands of Mans. It is there in the limbal conjunctiva. So now you will ask, where is the limbal conjunctiva, right? So in the bulbar conjunctiva, guys. So if you have the bulbar conjunctiva here, in that, the one that is right next to the cornea, that is the limbal conjunctiva marked here. So in this, what will you see? The glands of Mans. That will secrete what? The mucin. So that will form one part of this tear film. Okay. Then coming to what is this mucus layer? Basically, mucus layer is the innermost layer, okay, and it is converting the hydrophobic corneal surface into hydrophilic surface. So it's innermost, right? It converts hydrophobic corneal surface into hydrophilic one. Okay, so first of all, it did not like water, but because of this mucus layer, it started liking water. Now let us move on to aqueous layer. This is the bulk of the tear film. Okay, maximum it is this only. So it is secreted by the main and accessory lacrimal glands. So the lacrimal glands are actually secreting only the aqueous layer, main and accessory lacrimal glands secrete this main aqueous or watery layer of the tear film. Okay. Then, what is there in this? The tears, right? The tears come out of the lacrimal glands. It is also producing the aqueous layer for the tear film. The tears will comprise of what? The tears will comprise water and some solutes like sodium chloride, sugar, urea and protein. So, it is alkaline and salty in taste. Fine. It also has antibacterial substances like lysosome, beta-lysin and lactoferrin. So, this is where you have to focus a lot, because the lacrimal glands are actually secreting this part. What are they secreting? The aqueous layer, the tears. Basically, the tears are having what? Water, sodium chloride, sugar, urea, protein, and these are what? These are, this will make the tears alkaline and salty in taste, and they are also having antibacterial action because of lysozyme, beta-lysin and lactoferrin. Lysozyme, beta-lysin and lactoferrin. Okay. Good. Then lastly, we will move on to the lipid layer. So guys, in this video, we wanted to look at what? The tear film. So we have now reached the outermost layer. That's the lipid or the oily layer. This is the outermost and the thinnest. Okay. So it is formed at the air and the tear interface. Okay. So it is from the secretions of meibomian zeis and Moll glands. God, what names are these? The gland names are really complicated in this one, guys. Pay attention here. We'll try to type these names. M-E-I-B-O-M-E-M-I-A-N. Meibomian zeis and the Moll glands. Okay. Secreted by these. These are the outermost. This lipid layer is the outermost and the thinnest. Okay. And it is secreted by these glands. And then it prevents the overflow of tears, retards their evaporation, and it also lubricates the eyelids. Okay, guys. So, what are the functions of this layer? Basically, lubricate eyelid movement. So, eyelid movement will be easy. And then, what did we see? Prevent evaporation of the tears. Okay, that is another one. Then there was one more function of this lipid layer, that was prevent overflow of tears. Okay. Prevent the overflow of tears. Okay. So these are the, this is the tear film. Now, guys, what are the functions of this tear film? Now, let us look at the functions of the tear film. Tear film functions. Okay. So, the functions of the tear film are to keep the cornea and the conjunctiva moist. So, it will keep the cornea and the conjunctiva moist. It will provide oxygen to the corneal epithelium. To whom? To the corneal epithelium. It washes away the debris. Okay. And any noxious irritants, if there are any noxious irritants or debris, it will be, they'll be washed away. And then, you know, it has antibacterial action, so it will prevent infection. It will facilitate the movement of the lids, eyelids, okay, over the globe. So, these are the functions of the tear film. Okay, guys, who is actually producing these tears? The tears are being produced by the lacrimal gland. So, guys, the lacrimal gland produces the tear, but the tear film, alright, the tear film which is coming, only the middle part is actually the tear aqueous part which is coming from the lacrimal gland. The innermost part and the outermost part are coming from different sources. The innermost part is the mucus part which is coming from the conjunctival goblet cells and the glands of Mans. And the outermost part is coming from where? The oily layer, from those three crazy names, meibomian zeis and Moll glands. Okay. So, you have understood tear film is different from tear. Okay. So, now what happens if there is problem with this tear film? Okay. You will have dry eye, disease. Okay, when the tear film, there is loss of the homeostasis of the tear film, there will be dry eye disease. Okay, then you have something called as watery eye. Watery eye means it is characterized by overflow of tears because of hyperlacrimation. Okay. So this can happen because of hyperlacrimation, where the lacrimal secretions itself are more, or inadequate drainage can be there, and that is called as epiphora. Okay, guys. So in this video, we have looked at lacrimal apparatus. Okay. So far, what and all we have seen? Lacrimal apparatus, that is the lacrimal gland, the puncta, the canaliculi, the lacrimal sac, the nasolacrimal duct. All this we have seen. Then in this video, we saw the parts of the tear film, the mucus layer. The aqueous layer is actually coming from the lacrimal gland. This is what you have to focus on. Right? This is the main thing, because we are looking at the lacrimal secretions. Okay? Then you have the outermost, the lipid or the oily layer. So we have seen the functions of the tear film, and we will see what happens if there is problem with this tear film. Dry eye disease or watery eye disease can be there. Okay, guys, we'll meet you in the next video with some more details. That's all for now. Bye bye.